LIVINGSTONE Power, and thank you so much for watching my YouTube channel, and welcome to Anatomy 101. In this video, we're going to continue our conversation going over the thoracic cage. We're going to learn about the different parts of the sternum, also called the breastbone. We will learn about the sites where the thoracic cage connects to the spine. We will learn about the organs that the thoracic cage houses, and more. So we have an awesome video jam-packed with information for you. While you're watching the video, if you like it, please do me a favor and give the video a thumbs up. It'll really help me out by doing that. Also, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell for notifications. This is the 11th video in this video series, so if you haven't watched all of the videos, make sure you check the link above and you will have the link to the entire playlist. Alright guys, let's get right into the video. The sternum, also called the breastbone, is the medial, or in the middle, to the anterior, or front, of the thoracic cage. It is very flat in nature, giving it a lot of strength. It is long and divided into the manubrium, that is the uppermost part, the body that lies below the manubrium, and above the last part, which is the xiphoid process, that is pointing downwards. The manubrium and the body of the sternum have notches on their sides to provide articulation sites with the costal cartilages, in addition to the clavicle articulating with the manubrium on the fossets on the sides. Superiorly, or the upper manubrium, is laterally, meaning to the side, expanded, and has a jugular notch in its midline. The notch has a fossa that is oval-shaped on either side that provides articulation sites for the clavicle. Neonates and babies' xiphoid processes are independent to the sternum and only fuse later in life. The sternum. The xiphoid process has a cartilage as its precursor and later ossifies to form the xiphoid process. A thoracic vertebrae is the last component of the thoracic cage, and they have a higher mass as compared to the clavicle vertebrae. They are 12 in number and have a posteriorly protruding transverse process. It also has a spinous process that is very pointed and long, angling downwards, in addition to having facets on their sides for rib articulation. The thoracic vertebrae and xiphoid process. When a person reaches adulthood, the sternum and ribs are major sites of hemoptopoiesis, which is the site that creates blood. Despite being a major site for hemoptopoiesis, clinically when bone marrow is necessary for diagnosis, this is not a preferred aspiration site because the muscles covering it cannot be penetrated. This is because the ribs and the sternum most of the time cannot withstand the medical forces applied during the procedure. The thoracic cage houses major organs, mainly the respiratory organs, in addition to the heart and the upper parts of the kidneys. The diaphragm attaches to the inferior or bottom portion of the thoracic aperture, which means an open space like a cavity. The superior or upper thoracic aperture or cavity is small and provides attachments for the neck muscles and the pectoral muscles. Intercostal muscles fill the rib spacing, providing the stretching capabilities of the ribs during inhalation and the relaxing capabilities during expiration. They are cylindrically shaped to increase the surface area and provide protection to the delicate lungs and heart. This structure also houses major blood vessels and protects the spinal cord, while at the same time providing structural support to the upper abdomen. Its muscles link with those of the posterior or backside thoracic region with the anterior or front side thoracic regions. Ribs provide a surface area for attachments of these muscles, with a major tendon that originates from the sternum that runs all the way down to the pelvic bone, that provides an attachment site for the infamous rectus abdominis muscle. Thoracic vertebrae allow for the passage of the spinal cord that is heavily laden with nerves connecting to the central nervous system. Thoracic vertebrae are separated from each other with cartilaginous discs that act as a shock absorber, and they allow movement during breathing. Its clusters form part of the bigger vertebral column in conjunction with the lumbar vertebrae. The cervical vertebrae, sacral vertebrae, and the coccyx. All right guys, I really hope you liked that video going over the thoracic cage. I hope you learned so much in a very fun way, hopefully. Make sure you stay tuned because in the next video, we're going to go over the hips and the pelvis. So that's definitely gonna be very interesting. Also, if you happen to be studying anatomy and physiology, make sure you become a member of my channel because I've uploaded my best-selling program, How to Study for Anatomy and Physiology there. This program has been around for quite a while and it's helped thousands of students. In that program, I go through specifics on exactly how to study for this class because there's a ton of information, but there's a lot of fun ways to go through the information and to learn the information. So, all right guys, make sure you stay tuned and I will see you in the next video. Love you, bye.